The design tools you're about to see are largely unknown hidden gems that you need to add into your workflows in 2025. And first up, let's talk about Perplexity AI. Now, we all love a good deep dive into design trends, but let's be real here. Google isn't built for designers. It gives you scattered results, random links, and it's not exactly smart about what you actually need as a designer. Perplexity AI fixes just this. You can think of it as Google, but way more intelligent and way more useful for creatives. Let's say you're researching something like brutalist design trends or just brutalist design. Instead of opening up 10 different tabs, typing in 100 different searches, and digging through endless articles, you just ask the AI something like this. I need some case studies on how brutalism is growing within graphic design with examples. And boom, it pulls actual case studies out for you, visual examples, and market insights, all in seconds. You don't even need to refine your search, it just simply works. We can also go into the related results at the bottom as well, simply to further our knowledge on this subject. But I do love how it brings up neat visual examples as well, which is why this tool is useful for graphic designers when it comes to research, inspiration, and that sort of thing. It's also a massive time saver, especially if you do client work and need to pull out solid references fast. Next up, colors. Picking the right color palette can feel like an endless process at times for some designers. I mean, we've probably all been there at some point. You've got your color wheels, your swatches, inspiration, mood boards, and so on. And that is where Humint comes into play in this situation. This site isn't just a random palette generator. It actually applies your colors to actual designs in the real world. You can see how they might look on a brand identity, a website, even a magazine layout in real time. And here's the cool part. You can choose up to 3 colors yourself, and Humint will fill in the rest with AI-powered color matching. You can even upload an image to sample colors straight from. But the real magic is in the advanced settings. You can tweak contrast, adjust color harmony, and even switch between different AI modes to generate palettes that fit exactly what you need. Honestly, the only thing missing here is a text-based input where you could describe a mood or an emotion and have it generate palettes based around that. But even without that, this tool is an absolute must-have to graphic designers. Now, if you are an experienced graphic designer, you will for sure know this struggle. Clients sending you feedback in a string of emails, vague comments like make it pop, and never knowing which version is the final one. Sound familiar? As a result, projects slow down, deadlines get missed, and teams end up overwhelmed. But instead, you can streamline proofing and approvals with GoProof. This keeps everything, feedback, versions, and approvals organized in one place. And instead of scattered email threads, every comment and revision happens in real time, right on the design itself. So no more digging for that latest version, or no more second-guessing the feedback. And with GoProof's seamless integration with Monday.com, the entire review process becomes part of your existing workflow. So there's no need to switch between tools, because projects will stay on track and approvals will move faster. And if you're managing multiple design versions, GoProof offers automatic version control, allowing you to track changes effortlessly and compare versions side by side. And this obviously ensures that everyone is aligned on the latest iteration. And that means less back and forth, fewer headaches, and a more efficient creative process. Also with GoProof, you can invite an unlimited amount of collaborators to come and review your work. Clients and team members can leave precise on-screen annotations, providing clear, actionable input that guides your revisions. So instead of just make it pop, you get actionable input that actually does help. And to learn more about GoProof and how it can be very vital to your workflow, just click that link in the description box below. Now, let's talk about fonts. As the competent and awesome designers that I know the Satori clan is, I know that you know fonts can make or break a design. But finding high quality ones without breaking the bank, now that's pretty tough. Enter Font Share, probably one of the best kept secrets in typography. It's basically a Google Fonts alternative, but with a way better curation and a better UI layout. Almost everything here is 100% free for personal and commercial use. And the typefaces are actually good, like professional grade good. It even has some variable fonts, which means you can adjust weight and style dynamically, perfect for responsive web design as an example. And most of these fonts come with an open-ended license, meaning you can use them in branding, packaging, UI design, whatever you want. So there's no weird restrictions, no hidden fees, just high-quality fonts, free to use forever. And we can check that by coming down here and clicking on Close Source. And I'm just looking at this Satoshi font as an example. And if you scroll down, it literally says, "You are hereby granted a non-exclusive, non-assignable, non-transferable, terminable license to access, download, and use the font software for your personal or commercial use for a limited period of time for free of charge." So yeah, a lot of free fonts, but free fonts that actually look good and do function well on your designs. All right, next up, something a little futuristic, instant 3D model generation. If you've ever wanted to experiment with 3D graphics, AR, or UI UX visualization, but it felt like it was just maybe way too complicated, Meshy AI is your new best friend. This thing is insane. You just type in a description, upload an image, and within seconds, it gives you a full 3D model. So no complicated software, no hours of sculpting, just instant results. And it's not just rough models either. These are clean, well-structured 3D assets that can be exported and used in your projects. And this, of course, is perfect if you want to dabble in 3D, but you don't want to go full Blender mode just to get a simple concept. Now, this tool is a complete game changer to those who want to work with 3D elements, but don't have the time to build them from scratch. And lastly, something that will really make you think as a designer. Untools is a hidden gem for designers, but not in the way you might expect. Instead of generating assets, it provides mental models that help you think clearer, solve problems better, and make smarter design decisions. Whether you're working on branding, UI UX, or creative strategies, these frameworks help you approach design challenges with structure rather than guesswork. Tools like first principles thinking let you break down ideas down into their core, avoiding trends and creating truly original work. While inversion thinking flips problems around, asking what you would make a design fail instead of succeeding, and this helps you eliminate weak points before they happen. One of the best models here, in my opinion, for designers is the Eisenhower Matrix. And this helps you prioritize what actually matters instead of drowning in endless tasks. And if you need to figure out what to work on first, separate tasks into urgent versus important and cut the distractions. Untools isn't just about design. It's about design thinking, and that's what makes it such a powerful resource for any creative. If you've ever felt stuck or overwhelmed, these simple frameworks can help you see problems from new angles and design with more clarity. These tools are truly hidden gems for designers. It's a lot like the video content on my channel to improve your knowledge and your skills within graphic design. And to continue that educational journey, just click the video on screen. But until next time, guys, design your future today. Peace.